Welcome to the Rubber Depot. Thank you for your purchase of our do-it-yourself rubber surfacing system. We will walk you through a typical concrete pool surround installation. Preparing your base is very important. Prepare the base one day prior to installation of rubber deck. Remove all previous coatings, paint, and surfacing products before applying rubber deck to ensure a strong adhesion to the existing base. Power wash all loose debris, oil, and dirt from the existing surface. You may wish to fill in cracks in the concrete. Allow area to completely dry before installation. Preparing your skimmer. To prepare your skimmer, simply place a 3/8 plastic spacer to elevate your skimmer cap. Then spread Vaseline around the skimmer cap edge so your rubber will not stick. This will make it easier to remove once you have completed the installation. As you can see in the video, your skimmer lid is raised to the thickness of your finished surface. Preparing your pool coping edge. Preparing your pool coping edging is also recommended to create a clean finish around your pool and should be completed the day before installation of the rubber surface to allow significant dry time. Apply PL400 adhesive in 8-foot sections. Then apply a 3/8 flexible plastic edging around your pool coping. A sample piece is included in your starter kit. You can purchase flexible plastic edging at your local Home Depot. You may also place small concrete or wood blocks to hold the edge secure while the adhesive dries. For rounds and curves, you can simply cut the back of the edging to make it more flexible. Weather conditions are extremely important for a successful surface. A temperature in the range of a minimum of 50 degrees and a maximum of 91 is required. A forecast of no precipitation during the installation period is advised, as the materials are moisture cured and may set prematurely. Getting started. Let's open your starter kit. Inside you will find knee pads, trowels, WD-40, gloves, tarp, and instructions. You will need a wheelbarrow and a shovel. Here are a couple of helpful hints. You will need approximately 1 8-ounce can of WD-40 for every 200 square feet, so purchase that in advance. Spray all of your tools, shovels, and wheelbarrow with the WD-40. This will make it easier to clean up after installation. An important safety note. Always wear protective eyewear and a respirator. Also, your clothes and shoes may be stained during the process. You are now ready to mix the rubber. Place the supplied tarp under the area where you will mix. Place one bag of rubber in the wheelbarrow, then add the urethane from the supplied pail. The pail should be filled to the line marked Fill To line. Mix well for 3 to 5 minutes until the material has no dry rubber granules or clumps. The mixture should be consistent in its texture. If you are using a custom mixture of rubber deck colors, pre-mix the whole quantity of rubber to ensure consistency. Fill it back into the bags and then prepare one bag at a time as described. it is extremely important to mix the rubber thoroughly. Once your rubber is mixed with your urethane, you will have approximately 30 to 60 minutes of work time. Let's get started troweling. Let the fun begin. Start by shoveling small workable piles. Spread the rubber to a thickness of 3/8 of an inch. Once you have spread the rubber evenly, begin to smooth out by spraying your trowel with WD-40 so the rubber can be finished to a smooth, even finish. A couple of hints on troweling. Keep your trowel on a 30-degree angle and apply even pressure. Keep reapplying WD-40 to your trowel as required. After a couple of swipes, you will get the hang of it. It would be a good idea after your first mix to ensure that you have covered 40 square feet and that your thickness of your surface is proper. Repeat the process, but don't get ahead of yourself. Only finish what you can comfortably reach. An arm's length is recommended. Also, switch sides every once in a while so your oldest mix does not start to set up and become stiff. When close to the pool edge, ensure that no rubber fall in as it may stick to the bottom and sides. Remove the rubber as soon as possible. Depending on weather conditions, the surface will dry between 24 and 48 hours. You are now ready to start your surface. If at any time during your installation you need to ask a question, please call 1-855-565-5551 or visit our website at www.therubberdepot.com. Good luck!